I am a believer in that portion of the Declaration of American Independence in which it is set forth as among self-evident truths that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Hence, I am an abolitionist. Convince me that one man may rightfully make another man his slave, and I will no longer subscribe to the Declaration of Independence. Every slave is a stolen man. Every slaveholder is a man-stealer. By no precedent, no example, no law, no compact, no purchase, no bequest, no inheritance, no combination of circumstances is slaveholding right or justifiable. While a slave remains in his fetters, the land must have no rest. Whatever sanctions his doom must be pronounced accursed. The law that makes him a chattel is to be trampled underfoot. The compact that is formed at his expense and cemented with his blood is null and void. The church that consents to his enslavement is horribly atheistical. The religion that receives to its communion the enslaver is the embodiment of all criminality. Such, at least, is the verdict of my own soul. On the supposition that I am to be the slave, that my wife is to be sold from me for the vilest of purposes, that my children are to be torn from my arms and disposed of to the highest bidder, like sheep in the marketplace, living or dying, defeated or victorious, be it ours to exclaim, no compromise with slavery, liberty for each, for all, forever.